Hey everybody, Tom Lenfesti here on April 3rd with our daily counsel. Again, Mike and Lauren and I will try to bring this to you, on different facts, different resources, different updates that we have. We've been doing this now. This is the end of week two. So we'll probably continue to do this next week. We may kind of, continue to post to YouTube, social media, and kind of go that way. The emails may just kind of be escalated to, decreased to once a week. But hopefully you're still finding these as resources. We'll start to put them out there as different things continue to change or different ideas, solutions become available. So today we're gonna start with Mike. Mike, we know it's been a late night of SBA bank discussion. What can you tell us about the payroll protection program through the banks and the SBA's cooperation happening supposedly today? Question mark.
Right. Thanks, Tom. This is brought to you by caffeine. Caffeine, it's your friend. It has been. It's been around the clock. There's been updates coming in from the discussions between lenders and the SBA and the Treasury. And kind of like a high-level recap of where we are is today is the day. Very exciting time going live with the SBA loan application program. I'm sure the lenders are just as excited as I am, if not more, because they're actually having to handle these. To put it into some perspective, I read a statistic last night that last year the SBA was responsible for approximately $28 billion, I believe, in lending for the year. And this is about $350 billion in about a day, right? Or maybe a couple weeks span. So just to give you some perspective on the magnitude of what we're looking at from an influx of applications to local lenders, and then lenders having to turn those around, process, get approved, and then lend. So this is gonna be unprecedented. And needless to say, we've had some, bumps in the road, is fair to say. The high level understanding that I have of it, of where things are from the bank's perspective and concern, is real time. How do we know, how do we track, how do we understand as the fund that Congress has earmarked becomes depleted, so that the local lender can feel assured that when they lend money to a business, it is 100% guaranteed by the Fed and will be considered part of that pot of gold, if you will, that Congress has created, and not get some type of notice that says, sorry, when that loan was issued, the Congress fund was out of money and therefore it falls outside the scope. That's been being discussed, being worked on, I believe, through the night last night. And it seems like lenders are in a place today where they are considering going live with the application process, at least taking in those applications from the borrowers. And then what will processing look like? Time will tell. I imagine it will continue into next week. And then hopefully business owners can start seeing some relief with this Paycheck Protection Program funds being released to them. What I will say is we're working with a number of clients, assisting them to help them put together their application. While it's not a very complicated process, it is one that you really want to go through with your advisors, whether it's your CPA, your accountant, your attorney, whoever it might be, to make sure that the calculations are being done correctly with the payroll analysis, that you have the supporting documents, that you can have the package together to upload or submit with your lender as quickly as possible, so that you're given the best shot at being in line to receive those proceeds. So we are working with that. The other thing I wanted to just touch on in the realm of bumps in the road and issues that we're seeing, talking to a lot of business owners who are getting feedback from their employees that, the unemployment benefit process is not as user-friendly as maybe it once was or hoped to be. So we're seeing delays. There have been just an overwhelming number of applications, obviously, not just in North Carolina, but nationwide. And I think it is stressing the system to the brink. And as a result, we're seeing a lot of delay. And although the North Carolina website for unemployment benefits recites a 2-week turnaround for your first benefits check from unemployment, that may or may not be delayed. I think it's case by case basis, and I don't really have a way to track or look at where someone is in line. And I've heard reports from business owners ranging from, I have an employer portal, but it's not working, to I'm trying to get my employer portal created, but there's this roundabout, we'll send you a PIN, and if you can't wait, call us, and then you call and there's nobody answering the phone. And so that's a big headache. And then lastly, in the realm of bumps in the road and delay, the individual economic stimulus portion, the personal checks to family members, husband, wife, single, you know, and this sort of like measure of what you receive based on how many kids you have and all these things, the personal stimulus checks, it seems like there's sort of three buckets. There's the folks that the IRS already has on record with direct deposit. They may actually receive that money first and fairly quickly here, hopefully within the next couple of weeks. That's the report coming from Mr. Mnuchin. Then if you don't yet have direct deposit, they're creating some type of portal to log in and upload the information for direct deposit. Those folks would be a next grouping to come behind. And then unfortunately, if you can't or don't want to create a direct deposit for the IRS, the Treasury, they are going to mail checks, we believe. And I've heard reports ranging from, you know, 8 weeks up to as late as 5 months. August is when those checks could be going out. So again, the message here is there is help. Benefits are there. They are starting to flow, but this is a process that is a little bit log jammed, and it's going to take some time to trickle out and work through. My advice to folks is be as patient as possible. Work with your advisors, keep them close. The team at NC Planning is standing by as always. We're here to help with questions, to assist in processes. Let us know, and stay safe, everyone. We're all in it together, and we will hopefully see some funds flowing soon.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. And I think that's the point is, you know, overall, the government's moved pretty fast over the last week, meeting the SBA, but there's still a lot of confusion. And I know you and the team overall are trying to not only just be helpful in kind of putting those applications together, getting them over to lenders, but really we've received such mixed messages from lenders just based on them not getting the answers or confusion. It's knowing what truly is, you know, the rules and requirements or what is not. And so being an advocate for those borrowers and seeking those funds as well, I know is something you guys are doing. So thank you very much. And I'll turn it over to Lauren. Lauren, what can you tell us that's going on in your world or what you're seeing today?
Yeah, thanks, Tom. Thanks, Mike. And first and foremost, thanks to all of you for watching, for liking, subscribing, sharing openly. It's so good to be able to help in some small way. And if you're able to share this content with someone that it might help, thank you. Thank you for doing that. Wanted to touch base and kind of round out our week with some positivity here. Because it's a tough, scary, stressful time. Cases in North Carolina continue to go up, and it's just not great news is what seems to get the headlines. So wanted to touch base on a few things that we've been seeing. Of course, in the community, there's great work being done. People are finding creative ways to stay in touch. Like I've been invited to a few Zoom happy hours and things like that, cheering on hospital workers that are on their way to work. We've all seen those videos. Religious services are still streaming online, so we can still have that sense of community and still gather and worship. So again, a lot of new norms are needing to be reached, and focusing on some of the good that's coming of that as well, being able to reconnect with family that's far away and like, hey, let's do this new Zoom thing that everyone's been talking about. So again, it's trying to help in some small way. That's really what's been getting our team through. It is a busy, busy time for us, but we're all focusing on just helping in some small way, doing some good for business owners, for individuals, We're helping several people, but I wanted to share the story of helping an individual that is needing to transport their loved one. Their mother is in an assisted living community and her level of need has increased into a skilled nursing level of need. As you can imagine, what was already a difficult time in those transfers is now even more complex, even more stressful. So it's just, fortunately, being able to have that relationship with our clients and help guide along that path, talking to these God bless them saints at these nursing homes that are so overwhelmed, trying to have those open communications and talk about the logistics of that transfer, because openly, it's changing for them day to day as well. So taking some of that stress off of our clients and helping as much as we can throughout that process, and facilitating that transfer in a safe environment is huge for us. So again, it's focusing on how we can help. That's kind of what I wanted to end out this week with. There's a lot of great resources out there. If you want to try and help some way, again, it's doing what you can safely. If you are fortunate enough to be able to have the ability to help, WUNC.org has a great article right now. If you just go to their website, WUNC.org, there's a button in the top right corner for search. And if you search, quote unquote, how you can help, the name of the article is How You Can Help the North Carolina Community During the Coronavirus. So they've got a lot of different community organizations, such as Activate Good, the Food Bank of North Carolina, different ways to plug you in if you have a certain cause that is important to you. I worked in restaurants in undergrad, so giving back there a little bit to the workers that are affected. Anything you can do, every little bit helps, and it'll go directly into our community here in North Carolina and help those in need. So again, just taking a step back, it's a stressful, crazy time, but being thankful, being kind to one another. If you're out and about smiling at neighbors that you may have never even talked to before, those little connections can go a long way. So just everyone stay safe, stay well, do what you can, and be good to one another.
That's great, Lauren. And I'll try to include that link, in the video kind of updates for the YouTube post and then the email we send out, so we can definitely do that. But it is amazing to see how we can turn, as a community, as a society, negatives into positives, how everybody does really outreach to help. And I think the more that we can do that and focus on the positive, the easier it will be to get through this. Mike and Lauren, thank you both for the updates today. I know it's an extremely busy day, so I'll let you guys get back to it. I think the biggest thing that I actually saw yesterday that kind of, for me, is kind of my daily motivation is we're one day closer. One day closer to the end, right? So yeah. Just know that each day you're one day closer to this all being over, hopefully. Now, when that happens and everything to be determined, but you're one day closer, we've made it through. And the more positive we can do, the more we can continue on under this new adapted lifestyle, and hopefully get help to those that need it. We'll all come through this okay. So thanks, Lauren and Mike. Thanks, everybody else. And we'll go ahead and close it there for today.